Oh, it keeps muting me. Hold on.
We can hear you. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Okay, great. You could stay on mute until we get started, I guess.
Okay, and who is speaking?
This is Lucas. I'm just helping out with the Zoom today. I don't know if you could see me. I'm in the room.
Oh, okay. Nope, I can only see the where the board members would sit right now.
Hi.
Okay, not a problem. I just wanted to make sure I could be heard so that I could take the roll call.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I'd like to call to order the meeting. Please rise to salute the flag.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Why are we getting reverb? Okay. Counselor, may I have the Open Public Meeting Act statement, please?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, in compliance with NJSA 10:4, the Open Public Meetings Act, notice of this special meeting of the Jackson Township Planning Board has been published and posted in all appropriate locations.
Thank you. May I have a roll call, please?
For Monday, June 22nd, the Jackson Township Planning Board, Mr. Dolan is absent. Dr. Campbell?
Here.
Mr. Riker?
He's present.
Mr. Nigro? Mr. Nigro?
Present.
Mr. Jeswicki?
I'm here.
Mr. Wall?
Here.
Mr. Fleming?
Here.
Mr. Riccardi?
Here.
Mr. Herring?
Here.
Mr. Hudak?
Here. Okay, payment of voucher recording secretary for this evening, June 22nd, 2020. May I have a motion, please?
Second.
And roll call.
Dr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mr. Riker? Mr. Nigro?
Yes.
Mr. Jeswicki?
Yes.
Mr. Wall?
Yes.
Mr. Fleming?
Yes.
Mr. Riccardi?
Yes.
Mr. Herring?
Yes.
Mr. Hudak?
Yes. And may I also have, does anyone have any comments or questions? Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Payment of the Planning Board Secretary for this evening, June 22nd, 2020. I need a motion for that, please.
So moved.
Second.
And again, a roll call.
Dr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mr. Riker? Mr. Nigro?
Yes.
Mr. Jeswicki?
Yes.
Mr. Wall?
Yes.
Mr. Fleming?
Yes.
Mr. Riccardi?
Yes.
Mr. Herring?
Yes.
Mr. Hudak?
Yes. Engineering and planning matters. Gentlemen, do you have anything this evening? Thank you. Miscellaneous legal matters, Mr. Gartner, anything?
Mr. Chairman, no miscellaneous matter at your timing. I will talk about why we're here tonight as if you need assistance or any additional information.
So tonight we have a special meeting that was called to reschedule the application block 10401 17802 lots 5.04 5701 Jackson Park, the south section. So the purpose of this meeting tonight is to reschedule this to August 17th, 2020. We have no other applications on the schedule for that evening. So I believe there's going to be ample time for the applicant to present their application. And also there will be ample time at that meeting for residents and objectors and so forth to comment and ask questions regarding this application. And because of that, I am not going to accept any questions or comments from the audience because many of these questions would be answered by any of the testimony given on August 17th. So with that, May I have a, I'm sorry. This evening we have Mr. Tubal, who is the attorney representing Jackson Park South. Mr. Tubal, do you have anything to add?
Good evening, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, Jason Suvell on behalf of the applicant. Nothing substantively to add. We're in agreement. I did speak with Mr. Berner about August 17th being the date, which is fine and acceptable to us. All I'd ask, and I spoke with Mr. Gertner about this earlier, is that when the board makes the announcement carrying the application to August 17th, that in the event that it is live, which we're hoping that it is back to the normal course,
yes.
That it, the date, time, location is announced. But in the alternative, in the event we are still in this virtual world, you know, which is out of our control, that it is announced by the board that that the public should check the township website at least 10 days in advance for the website information regarding how they view the meeting, as well as the telephone number and where the plans could be on file. So when it's carried, all I'd ask is that it just be carried both ways so that the public is fully informed based upon the platform we're dealt with at that time.
Yes, so, perfect. I'm in agreement 100% with that. Thank you.
That's it.
Mr. Chairman, just one, if I may add just one small item to that, Mr. Chairman, just so the public and the board, quite frankly, are not confused, the location of the documents is not going to change between now and the 17th, where they are in the township website. So between now and then, the public should any member of the public wish to review those documents, they are currently on the website with the link, and certainly more than happy to accommodate the public in terms of looking at that site.
And my understanding too is if somebody wanted to make an appointment with Denise to view the plans, they could still do that as well, which is good.
Yes. Does anyone have any comments, questions, or concerns regarding this application? Yes, Mr. Klee.
Well, we only, I think, testified for 10 or 5 to 10 minutes last time. So I would just start from scratch again. That way it's we're starting from the beginning.
Okay. Yeah. Thank
that's
you.
The right thing to do.
Anyone else? Questions? Comments? No? Everybody good?
Yep.
Okay.
Before you go, I'd like to thank Mr. Wall for getting our IT going here.
Yes.
Well, we apologize to the public for any inconvenience on both this or any other meeting, and appreciate the vendors coming in to make sure that working with our IT team, that the process is professional, top-notch moving forward in the event that you have to have a meeting that has a hybrid or an all Zoom approach. Just a brief housekeeping note, as you saw the gentleman walk over to one of our professionals, if you're not speaking clearly into the microphone, you need to understand you're really not speaking. So just generically, that's critically important to make sure that you have a clear record for the staff, for any related transcripts and things of that nature. So we are working with technology. And just if you may just indulge a brief moment, Lucas, are there any key points that everybody here or in the public should understand to be able to optimize the experience, both for the professionals, for the volunteer board members, for the applicants, and particularly for the public that's watching? Can you give some key points and how to maximize the technology and to work together to ensure a productive and positive meeting?
Yes, we've moved over to a webinar service for Zoom, which is a service that's set up exactly for what you're trying to accomplish here, which allows panelists, which is this room or any other board members or things like that need to present. And then the public is on a watch and listen only basis. And then you will have control when it's time for a public comment to allow one by one people to speak. That makes the meeting go much more smoothly because basically you're not going to have interruptions or inappropriate behavior, things like that. So it's a little different today for everyone, especially the attendees. You can only listen in here, but when it's time to public comment in a traditional meeting, you'll be given that opportunity. And then just for all the people in the room here, like we said, talking into the microphone is very, very important.
And to clarify, for the public to actively engage with their boards at the appropriate time, what is the format that'll be utilized? Just so I see some chat comments about participation. What is the means and methods through which the public interacts with the applicants, the boards, et cetera, during public hearing or public comment?
The best way to go about that, when the public comment section comes, we'll instruct the public, if you would like to speak, use the raise your hand function. This is shown on your screen, depending on which device you have. It might be in a different place, but usually it's, if you click the center of your screen, you'll see it at the bottom. And when you press the raise your hand, you'll be given, you know, one by one, we'll give, you know, we can't have everyone talking at once, the opportunity to speak. If you want, it could be discussed, or if you want to use the chat function, but I think mainly the raise your hand is going to be best, because it's going to be allow people to speak audio, and then we'll be able to, you know, give them their time to speak, and then you guys can respond.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. That really come a long way in a week. Thank you. Okay, now do we have to do anything with time waived or date completed?
No, Mr. Chairman.
Sorry.
No, Mr. Chairman. This is actually a good segue. As I know many members of the public are aware, Judge Troncone issued orally a ruling that affected both this application and the North application. And the reason why we're here is pursuant to the court order that we expect to see in writing shortly. One aspect of that court order was to set the meeting anytime between August 10th and August 27th. August 17th was generally chosen because it's a regular meeting in any event. I'm not going to go into the balance of the order because it's not in writing it at this point. It wouldn't be appropriate. And since special meeting, there's no executive session permitted, and the board certainly should have the opportunity to review that that written order as well. A long-winded way, but I took advantage of the segue mm-hmm. to articulate the fact that there's no need for a waiver of time because that court order will address that August 17th date.
Mr. Duval, you're in agreement?
Yeah, that's correct. The judge in his oral decision stated that we are to have a meeting during the time frame that Mr. Gertner indicated. So he is correct.
Good. Okay. All right. With that said, anything else? Anybody have anything they want to share? No? All right. Can I get a motion to move this meeting to our August 17th, 2020 meeting?
And Mr. Chairman, that motion should include the articulation by the applicant relating to the August 17th meeting, that it is being carried without the need for further notice, because pursuant to that court order, we're all and hopeful that the meeting will be live. If, however, the meeting cannot be live, the municipality will post at least 10 days in all likelihood before that, but at least 10 days prior, the meeting link, the phone link, if folks don't have the opportunity to utilize the Zoom, and re-articulate and re-notify the public as to where the documents are located. And that at this meeting, and I would respectfully ask Mr. Chairman, that at every public meeting moving forward, we continue to at least notify the public so it's part of the record about how that August 17th meeting will be run.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Sean, just to be extra careful, August 17th, 2020, at 7:30 p.m., if it's live, it's in this room.
Yes, sir.
Hopefully, yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. So someone needs to make the motion with everything. Second. And can I have a roll call, please?
Dr. Campbell?
Yes.
Mr. Riker? Mr. Nigro?
Yes.
Mr. Jaswicki? Mr. Wall?
Yes.
Mr. Fleming? Mr. Riccardi? Mr. Herring?
Yes.
Mr. Hudak?
Yes.
Okay, with that being said, I have a motion to adjourn, please.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Meeting is adjourned.